Investigators begin the painstaking task of sorting through the wreckage of Flight 2311. They're searching for any evidence that might hint at why the Embraer 120 rolled sharply to the left and crashed, killing everyone on board. Deep inside the propeller unit, investigators uncover an important clue.
Aha! There you are. We have a witness mark. Take a look.
There's a small mark where two parts of the propeller mechanism slammed together on impact. The witness mark might be enough to tell investigators how the propellers were operating. The marks tell Ritter the exact angle of the blades when the plane slammed into the ground.
These guys had a big problem with their left propeller. The blades were almost flat.
The left side propeller blades are at a dangerously low angle, one that is never used during flight. At 3 degrees, the blades are so flat they would act like a wall, blocking the flow of air the plane needs to maintain lift. Investigators study the mechanism used to control the left propeller.
Will you look at this?
They make a disturbing discovery.
It's completely worn down.
The teeth on a key piece of the gear mechanism, known as the quill, are almost entirely worn away. Investigators may finally have the lead they've been looking for.
This is what it's supposed to look like.
With its teeth worn away, the quill can't lock onto the gear system that controls the angle of the propeller blades. The discovery might explain why the propeller blades slipped to such a dangerously low angle.
Once we noticed that the quill teeth were severely worn, we started theorizing what would happen in that type of situation. And it was pretty clear that control of the propeller blade angles could be lost.
Ritter is certain he's found the critical clue. Worn down teeth on the quill that could have allowed the propeller blades to slip to a dangerous angle. But he soon learns there's a big problem with his theory. The manufacturer says it's impossible. Engineers at Hamilton Standard included a fail-safe feature when they designed the propeller. It should be impossible for the blades to go flat during flight. If there's ever a problem with the mechanism controlling the angle, the blades are designed to move on their own to what's called the feathered position. A feathered propeller can't endanger the safety of the flight.
This has got to be it. This has to be connected somehow.
But Ritter isn't convinced by the manufacturer's assurances. His gut tells him the worn quill did allow the propeller blades to move to a dangerous angle. But without flight data, his investigation has hit a wall. He has no way to prove the quill brought down Flight 2311.
What's going on?
Can you see anything?
There's nothing.